I was going to get a preview of the operational deflection shape. So one of the reasons we were getting geometry ready in Neo is 2206 has the first release of the operational data animation in Neo. So I'm going to show that to you now. Here I have some EPROREP data. And if I look at my add-ins here, I turned on the operational data animation license. This is 28 tokens. So it's the same tokens, the number of tokens as classic operational deflection shape. So if you own classic operational deflection shape in classic test lab, or if you have 28 tokens, you can use it in 2206 Neo. So here I have a flat plate with some EPROREP data. So it's animating at this cursor position. I can tell it to jump to the next local max, and I'm animating that first peak. So I can manually find these peaks, or I can tell it to automatically add these operational points between peaks. So I'm going to add maybe 8 between 1,000 hertz and 6,000 hertz. I have some parameters I can tweak to avoid noisy area. Hit OK. And it looks like it missed the peak in the middle here, but it got most of the rest. So if I want to do that again, I can tell it maybe change it to 12. Hit OK. It's got operation points already. I'm going to remove those. And now it found all those points. So I can double click on the first operating point to look at 12, 17 hertz, or double click on the next one to look at 12, 602. Or I can scroll in the bottom. And these ones are scroll by frequency. The outer ones are scroll by operating points. So I can quickly jump through each of these operating points of this brake loader EPROREP data. And it works for steady state data that's a spectrum, cross powers, auto powers, or EPROREP, like I show here. I can also animate order sections and frequency sections if I want. Or if I have another project where I have waterfall data, I can animate this waterfall data automatically. And here I have 60 waterfalls on this truck cab. And if I wanted to look at this order here, and I wanted to animate that operational data point, there I can see that cab twisting. If I wanted to see what's happening due to that order at a higher speed, I can start to see what that looks like. Or if I wanted to, I can go to any one of these orders. And then basically, you can move the cursor and the motion doesn't change until I release the cursor. And then you can start to see what it's doing. And this is something we can't do in classic test lab. In classic test lab, you can only animate 2D data. But here in Neo, we can animate the same 2D data we can do in classic. Plus, we can animate directly from the waterfall data. And this is actually an old CADX database I had. But if you have any tracking axis, I can switch from this to time or to any available Z axis. So if you had any static channels you measured, I can switch to any of those static channels and animate those as well. So there's a pull down here for tracking channel, and you choose time or one of your tacos or one of your static channels. You can animate directly on the waterfall data. So that's a preview of the animation in Test Lab Neo.